What is up, Pats Nation? It is Patriots Global here with another video, and today we are going to be talking about wide receiver Paul Turner. The Pats signed the free agent after releasing tight end Troy Nicholas. That was a guy that the Pats signed just a few months ago. He was a guy that came off of a career with the Arizona Cardinals. Ending college was actually said to be like a Rob Gronkowski, but after not hearing anything about this guy through minicamp, OTAs, or even really seeing him when I was at the first day of training camp, it really wasn't a surprise that he got cut. Now, Turner is 5'11", he's 25 years old, and 185 pounds, so still a pretty young guy, but does not bring much height or a build to our wide receiver corps. Now, Turner didn't get to play last season and hasn't played an NFL game in, get this, 20 months. That is almost 2 years that this guy has played since he's played in an NFL game. But after being released by the Philadelphia Eagles last September after suffering a shoulder injury and then waived by the New Orleans Saints in June, the second-year receiver never stopped believing that a team would just at some point give him an opportunity. In fact, he was overjoyed when his agent called saying that the Pats just wanted to bring him in for a workout. He really just wants one more chance at least to prove that he can be a quality receiver in the NFL. Now, the Pats signed him Friday, which was a day after the first day of training camp, and his first day that he participated in training camp was this past Saturday. Now, with that being said, there has been no word on him during training camp whatsoever. There's been no word on him even being there, although he actually was there. I saw pictures of him there. But in the recaps I read of the training camp days, he was nowhere to be seen. And what I mean by that is it never said, like, he caught a pass from Brady, he looked good, he looked sharp, there was just nothing about him. So when I finally found out that he was there, I was actually a little bit surprised because, like I've been saying, I literally have not heard a single thing about this guy. Now, I read reports that said that Turner spent a very long time after training camp practices that were already 2+ hours itself in the blazing hot and very humid air, but working with quarterback Danny Etling and just trying to catch up, so the determination is definitely there for Paul Turner. I mean, the fact that he goes in and has these 2+ hour long training camp days in the very hot and humid air, and then puts in a couple more hours with Danny Etling just to try to get caught up. I really like to hear that kind of stuff. So a little bit more about this guy. After going through the 2016 NFL draft unsigned, Turner was finally signed by the Philadelphia Eagles and just made their practice squad. He caught the team's attention with a 71-yard punt return for a touchdown in the preseason before being promoted to the active roster late in the season. Turner then went on to play 4 games, making 9 receptions for 129 yards with 3 catches of 16 yards plus. So now comes the real question, the question that everybody is wondering and possibly why you even clicked on this video. So what are the chances that Paul Turner actually makes the 53-man roster in the end? Well, from what I can hear, he is very versatile, he brings good character, and has so much to prove along with some pretty decent talent, but his chances just are not on his side. He's coming in very, very late into the process, and I mean, there isn't too much longer of training camp, and he needs to learn the very complicated playbook, and he's actually even said that it is a very complicated playbook, but he is very determined to learn it. Not to mention that he's competing for a spot at the position that is the most stacked for the Patriots, even with all the injuries that they have piling up at wide receiver. Ultimately, he's really just going to need that he can be a good backup wide receiver, as I think his best chance to make the team is through the practice squad at this point. Like I said, the Pats are already having issues with injured receivers, so I do like the depth signing a lot, and if he was signed earlier, then maybe things would be different for him. Maybe I would be saying I think he will make the 53-man roster, but we don't know that because it didn't happen. But with his name not popping up at all and coming in so late, I just don't see him making the team in the end. But that's it for today's video. What do you guys think of Paul Turner? I mean, he's proved himself before when he was an Eagle. He was actually a fan favorite until he started to fall off and injuries got in the way. It's also been a very, very long time since he's been in an NFL game, so that's also a little concerning. But what do you guys think of him? Make sure you guys like and subscribe as it helps me out so, so, so much, guys. We are about to hit 1,000. We just hit a little over 900, so that is just freaking amazing. Let's keep grinding. Make sure you guys share this with your friends so that we can grow the Patriots global family. But other than that, I'll catch you in another video, Pats Nation. We'll get it.